Hi, good evening. This is Dr. Mukesh Tiwari. As you all know that in first video of EKG, we talk about the how to apply the leads in our jaw to take ECG. In this video, we'll talk about how to interpret EKG in the simplest way. So, for making you understand, I have made some diagrams. You guys will come close so that the diagrams will be visible. First diagram is of heart. Basically, this is the basic structure of heart. In heart, as you all know, there are four chambers. One is right atrium, second one is the left atrium, then right ventricle and left ventricle. Okay, in the right atrium, there is a red dot which represents the SA node, which is located there in the upper side of the right atrium. Here, impulses get starts basically. And from this SA node, impulses travels to the AV node, which is located here in between the right auricle and right ventricle. Okay, so this is the AV node, and from the AV node impulses travels to the bundle of His, which is located here between the two ventricles. Then this bundle of His divides into the right and left bundle branches, and from these bundle branches impulses travels to the Purkinje fibers, which are located there in the wall of the ventricle. So in this way impulses travels in the heart, first from the SA node, which is known as the pacemaker, and from the pacemaker it travels to the AV node, from AV node to the bundle of His, from the bundle of His to the bundle branches, and from the bundle branches it travels to the Purkinje fibers. Okay, now this is the basic diagram of an EKG. In an EKG, there is a P wave, there is a QRS complex, there is T wave, there is PR interval, and there is QRS complex. Okay, these are the basic things which are there in a EKG. First, this P wave. This P wave basically represents the contraction or depolarization of the atrium. Okay, and then there is a QRS complex, which represents the ventricular depolarization or contractions. Okay, this QRS complex looks like a inverted V, so it represents the ventricular depolarization. Then there is a small bump, that is T wave, which represents the ventricular relaxation. Every after the contraction there is a relaxation. So now the question arises, where is the atrial repolarization? Actually, there are a lot of muscles in the ventricle, so the QRS complex is very tall, so it masks the relaxation of the atrium. So the relaxation of atrium will lie here somewhere. Okay, so this is the basic diagram of an EKG. Now we'll talk how to interpret an EKG in five steps. Before telling this, I would like to explain the basic structure of EKG. In an EKG strip, as you can see, there are big boxes. Okay, there are big boxes. This is the enlarged diagram of this big box, one big box. In one big box, there are five small boxes. Okay, and each small box represents the 0.04 seconds. So one big box is equal to 0.04 into 5 is equal to 0.20 seconds. Okay, that means one big box represents 0.20 seconds. Now, how to interpret EKG in five steps. First, we used to see determination of P wave. In every EKG, we should first see whether the P wave is there or not. Generally, P wave is upright in a normal EKG, like this. But in some cases, P wave is notched or biphasic. If P wave is notched or biphasic, it represents the atrial enlargement. Okay, now we used to see the PR interval. PR interval is the distance from the beginning of P wave to the beginning of QRS complex. And this PR interval should not be more than 0.12 seconds to 0.20 seconds. That means it should not be more than one big box. One big box is equal to 0.20 seconds. So this PR interval should not be more than one big box. If it is more than that, it represents the cardiac block. Okay, then there is QRS interval. QRS interval starts from the end of P wave to the beginning of T wave. So this interval should not be more than 0.06 0.06 to 0.12 seconds. If it is more than 0.12 seconds, then it shows some cardiac block. There must be some AV block. Okay, here in the diagram here. Okay, now there is a small T wave. Okay, and then we used to see whether the rhythm is regular or not. In an EKG, to estimate whether the rhythm is regular or not, we have to see the distance between the two R wave. Okay, if the distance between the two R wave is constant, that means that is a regular rhythm. In this, you can see the distance between the two R wave is constant. That shows this is a regular rhythm. While here in this graph, you can see distance between the two R wave is not constant. So this is not a regular rhythm. So in this way, we can estimate whether the rhythm is regular or not. Now the heart rate. For estimating the heart rate, we have to see whether the rhythm is regular or not, because in regular formula is different, and in case of irregular rhythm there is different formula. Actually, in case of regular rhythm, we have to count the number of big boxes between the two R wave. Like in this diagram, between two R wave there are three big boxes. So we can divide 300 by 3, which is the number of big boxes. So the number of the heart rate is 100. Our magic number in this is 300. We have to divide the 300 by number of big boxes between the two R wave in case of a regular rhythm. While in case of a irregular rhythm, we use a 6-second strip formula. In a 6-second strip, actually, as I have told you, one big box is equal to 0.20 seconds. So in a 6-second, there are 30 big boxes. So these two black lines, in these two black lines, there are 30 big boxes. So in case of irregular rhythm, we used to count the number of R waves between the 30 big boxes, or in a 6-second strip. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. So there are 7 R waves in a 6-second strip. So we have to multiply 7 by 10. So in this case, heart rate is 70. Okay, so first we have to see whether this is 6-second strip or not. And then we have to calculate the number of R waves between in a 6-second strip, or in between 30 boxes, and multiply by 10. So it will give us the heart rate. So these are the 5 basic steps by which we can interpret an EKG as fast as possible. Hope these tips will help you in understanding an EKG better. In next video, we'll talk about the cardiac blockage and all. I tried my best to explain. You hope you like this video. If you like my video, please give you a thumbs up and subscribe my channel. Thank you. Thank you very much.